Hi, welcome to St.
Petersburg News on Channel 4. I'm Carolyn, and this is my co-host, Triangle.
It's pronounced Eve. My name is Eve. My mom liked the spelling.
Anyway, let's get on to the news report.
Once again, Tom Sawyer tried to get away with another mischievous act.
Let's go to the scene.
Tom, it was melon warm in school today, wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
Powerful warm, wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
Didn't you want to go swimming now, Tom?
Well, no, not very much.
But you ain't too warm now.
Some of the boys and I pumped on their heads. See, my head's damp.
Tom, you didn't have to undo your shirt collar where I sewed it to pump on your heads now, did you? Unbutton your jacket. Father, well, go along now. I made sure that you play hooky and want to swim in, but I forgive you, Tom. You're kind of a singed cat, as the saying goes. Better look this time.
Well, now, if I didn't think you sewed it with white thread, but it's black.
Why? I did sew it with white thread. Tom!
Sydney, I'll lick you for that.
If Sid hadn't ratted Tom out, he might have gotten away with it.
I think Aunt Polly would have caught him.
Well, Aunt Polly's not the brightest person.
Let's take a break. We'll be back with news in a minute.
Hi, I'm Catherine Barley, and I'm the proud owner of Barley Rafts. If you don't want to get wet, I'll bet you love this raft, for we make high-quality rafts for a cheap price. So come on down and get your Barley Raft today.
Barley Raft, Barley Raft, come on down and get your Barley Raft. Barley Raft, Barley Raft, only $8.99. Barley Raft!
Do you want to learn how to play that? Well, you can come on down to St. Petersburg Piano Lessons. So come on down and sign up for lessons today. Tom Sawyer, Huckleberry Finn, and Joe Harper snuck off to a secret island. Let's roll the footage.
I reckon so. Anyways, I'm suited. I don't want nothing better than this. I don't ever get enough to eat. I don't even hear the kid coming to get a fella and fully back. So
it's just for like me. You don't have to get up in the morning. You don't have to go to school. You don't gotta wash. You don't get the plain foolishness.
You see, a pirate don't have to do anything, Joe. When he's ashore for a hermit, he has to be praying considerable. And then he don't have any friends. Anyway, all by himself that way.
You see, people don't go hermit nowadays like they used to in the old times. A pirate's always respected. He's gotta find the hardest place he could see and put sackcloth on his head and ashes. And he's gotta stand in the rain.
What is it for the sackcloth and ashes on his head for?
I know, it's got to do it though.
I'd dirt if I would.
Well, what would you do then?
I don't know, but I wouldn't do that.
Well, how would you get around it?
I just wouldn't stand it. I would run away.
Run away? That'd be a disgrace. You would know disgrace of
what pirates have to do.
Well, they got bone time, so they take the ship, burn them down. The people that they killed, they bury them in the island where ghosts are. And they,
and they make people walk the plank.
Oh, but they, and they carry the women to the island. But they don't kill the women.
No, they don't kill the women. They're noble and beautiful.
And don't they wear the bully's clothes? Oh, no. They wear gold and silver and diamonds.
Who?
Why, the pirates.
I reckon I ain't fit enough to be a pirate. I ain't got nothing but these.
We have tragic news. Doc Robinson was murdered last night. He was attempting a grave robbery. There's a police dog sniffing for clues, and Injun Joe and Muff Potter here to talk with me. So, who was there last night?
It was Muff, the dog, and me, as far as I know.
What were y'all doing?
Oh, we was digging.
Digging what?
Oh, well, we was digging up old Hoss Williams, much as I know.
Anything else?
Why, the dog and Muff got into a fight. Muff pulled out a knife out of nowhere, and he killed him.
Why'd you kill him?
Why? Because he has, for no reason whatsoever, he has no remorse for anyone to be locked up forever.
Do you have any remorse?
Well, of course I do.
Of course? What? You're just a cold-blooded soul, just like I said. And you should be locked up forever there, Muff.
No, I shouldn't.
Yes, you should.
No, you
shouldn't. Well, you heard it live. Go back to the studio. Next up, we have Tom, a sneaky entrepreneur that's running a business and tricking kids.
Here's the footage from a few days ago.
Hiya there, Tom.
Oh, hey, Ben. Didn't even know it was you.
Said, Tom, you want to come and swimming with me?
I can't. I'm whitewashing.
Whitewashing? What do you want to do work for?
This ain't work. It's fun.
Fun? That ain't look too fun. Say, Tom, why don't you let me whitewash a little?
I don't know. Aunt Polly wouldn't even let Sid do it.
But I promise to be careful. It's a hard job.
Real careful.
Say, Ben, you got anything for me?
All I got is a magic rock. Said to do anything for you.
Anything?
Anything.
Well, sure. Here's a paintbrush.
Thanks, Tom.
Hey, Tom, can I whitewash?
I don't know. It's a really hard job.
I got some marbles.
Sure. I don't have an extra paintbrush. You can use mine.
Thanks so much, Tom.
Breaking news. Tim Sawyer just confessed.
You mean Tom?
It's Tim.
Tom.
Tim.
It's Tom.
Tim.
Tom.
Tim. Breaking news. Tim Sawyer just confessed.
Tom Sawyer just confessed that he saw Injun Joe murder Doc Robinson, and he got away before he could get arrested.
More information will be provided tonight at 11.
Well, that's it. Remember, don't be a boor and watch Channel 4.
Tom, you didn't have to undo your shirt collar where I sewed it when you went swim when you pumped on your head now, did you?
Yes. Aiden, can you please tell your parents to stop looking the door? This is a sweat!
Joe murder Doc Robinson, and now he escaped before.